That's a great aerial view, isn't it, of the Impact Arena complex. It's a huge one in Wong Tong Tani, part of Bangkok, north of the city. And this is where effectively the bubble is here for the YONEX Thailand Open. In fact, for the three tournaments here in Thailand, as we look at the order of play on court two on day two, as we're still in the opening rounds. Here's what's happened so far. We had Angus Unkarlong beating Mark Kalyao, and then John Kong Kedrin, a fantastic win against Lam Sfus and Seidel. Cho Chen Chen, after a bit of a bobble at the start, beating Tanong Suk. And coming up shortly, we will have mixed doubles. Nicholas Nohr and Amalie Magelund of Denmark up against Praveen Jordan and Melati Deva Oktavianti of Indonesia. And they are the second seeds in the competition. They will play Rivaldi Mantari or Jomko and Paul Sampran. Jomko, of course, we just spoke about, who was in action here with a fine win over the German opponents. We have seen some pretty prominent upsets on this court, and it would be quite something if Nicholas Nohr and Amalie Magelund could do that. Over the very impressive Praveen Jordan and Melati Oktavianti. Just awaiting the players to come through.
On court two.
Here we go.
Mixed double. Niklas Nohr and Amalie Magelund from Denmark.
So the Danes coming out first.
Versus Praveen Jordan and Melati Deva Oktavianti from Indonesia.
So the Danes out first.
Daruni Masompong from Thailand.
Service judge, European Women's Team Championships gold medal winner in 2020. Botswana. And her partner, Nicholas Nohr, much more experienced. Gold medal at the European Games in 2015. European Mixed Team Championships got gold as well in 2019. Has had his injury problems in the past. Serious knee operation which kept him out for 1 year. Tough times for him against this very impressive pair. Of Oktavianti and Jordan. Who've not really been together for that long. Remember, Oktavianti, Jordan was with Debbie Susanto before.
So is, okay. What is it? What just says?
And did very well, of course, won All England with her, but he's also won All England with Oktavianti. So they are already a pair to be reckoned with. Nicholas Nohr, 29.185 centimetres. Nice rank of 16 with Sarah Tigerson.
And
left-hander as well. And his partner, Amalie Magelund, just 20 years of age, 166 centimetres tall, and from Roskilde, Denmark. Her highest ranking of 84th is Mikkel Mikkelsen. These two will be one of the big favourites here to take the title. Praveen Jordan, what a player he can be. 27.181 centimetres, fourth in the world from Bontang. And we talked about his former partner, Debbie Susanto. They were second in the world. They're not far from that right now with Oktavianti. He's 168 centimetres tall, 26 years of age, from Serang in Indonesia. Bronze medalist at the 2019 Sudirman Cup. Won the gold in 2019 mixed doubles Southeast Asian Games, along with her partner here. They've had a very good 2019. When they started working together after Debbie Susanto retired. Daruni Masopong, the umpire. Emmanuel Gabo Tsetsele of Botswana is the service judge. Yeah, since he's got together with Oktavianti, really been superb. But he won All England, remember? He's won it twice now. Got to the Thailand Open. Debbie Susanto, runner-up here in 2015. Praveen Jordan. So they will go into this, the outstanding favourites here. And as we've seen, that doesn't always mean
ladies
things will go with the form book.
On my right, Praveen Jordan and Malati Deifa Oktavianti, Indonesia. And on my left, Amali Magelund and Niklas Nohr, Denmark. Praveen Jordan to serve to Niklas Nohr. Love all. Play. Fourth.
Well, we do know Praveen Jordan is a real power player, isn't he? But can go two ways, of course. Will always look to be get on the front foot. Talked up his power and then he disguises that beautifully.
Service over. 1-2.
To work there from Nohr. Got away with that one, didn't they? Nohr and Magelund.
3-0.
Just getting in each other's way. And Jordan went for that shot.
So it's over. 4-3.
these two have not played each other before. So it's also about sizing each other up a little bit. Maybe that element of surprise.
Service over. Five.
It's definitely not like they're running away with this at the moment. Jordan and Oktavianti. Keeping pace with each other at the moment. Certainly trying to play his shots, isn't he, Praveen Jordan? As we'd expect him to.
Service over. 6-5.
Two-point lead so far, the biggest one anyone's had so far. And that's pinned back immediately.
8-5. Nine, five.
The most recently played before this tournament in the Salo Lux, losing the round of 32 in October, just earlier than that. Sorry, the Salo Lux and the, they got to the quarterfinals. That's nicely done by Praveen Jordan. And prior to that, they played in the Danish Open earlier in October. Got to the round of 16.
11-5 interval.
And they've just started to assert themselves more, haven't they? Jordan and Oktavianti, they go into the interval. 11-5 up here. Mistakes like that.
12-6.
And unforced errors against a good pairing like Jordan and Oktavianti.
Out. So it's over. 7-12.
And they too can make those mistakes. Jordan and Oktavianti. So goes both ways. Getting a very slight reprimand there from the umpire. Perhaps the Danish pair of field justice is served there. Well, they did well, their reaction there from Jordan Oktavianti,
nine,
but
12.
Nohr Magelund make no mistake in the second time of asking. Nohr's already been in action in this tournament, winning his men's doubles match with Matthias Christiansen. First time they've gotten each other's way, but this time it didn't quite work out for the Danish pair. Played that one,
11,
Jordan.
14.
Still looking pretty good, despite their last bit of action being in March. That was at All England, which I told you they mentioned they'd won. They beat Dechapol, Bravo Randacroix and Subsidy Teratanachai, who they are quite likely to meet at some point in this tournament. Very nicely placed by Magelund.
12,
and they are beginning
14.
To narrow that deficit as well, which was 5 points earlier on.
Play.
Excellent recovery. Really nicely done by Oktavianti.
15-12.
They really deserved that point, didn't they? After the hard work they put into it. Looked a lost cause for a minute. Give a lot of credit to Nohr and Magelund. They've battled back so well here, and now just 1 point between them. To what we saw just a couple of minutes ago, except the other way around. More like it from
15.
Jordan and Oktavianti. That's pretty emphatic from her. Oktavianti, right at the net.
Service over. 16, 17.
It was a bit of a careless point to give away, wasn't it? Talking of which, it's
18,
rather
16.
Unforced. Again, you just get the impression that Jordan and Oktavianti are not quite at their best yet. And that's giving Nohr Magelund some hope here. Okay. Too long.
19, 17.
Oh, it's always a difficult one. It's always a harsh one, isn't it? That, especially at this point in a game. But those are the rules. Just taking a little too long. And that has given Jordan Oktavianti three game points here. You can see it was Jordan who was directing operations from the back, trying to maneuver his opponents around the court. And they've taken that first game. 21-17, and Nicholas Nohr goes right past the umpire 17. And makes his feelings known about that service fault for undue delay.
On court one, women's single, Yeo Jiao Ming from Singapore. Versus Rasyonok Intanon from Thailand.
Men det er vigtigt at komme frem. Jeg kan ikke stå her. Sådan her,
ikke? Umpire Ivo Kaso from Switzerland. Service judge Wahyana from Indonesia.
That's a good start here for Nohr Magelund.
Two, love.
Sometimes that little sense of injustice, or perceived injustice anyway, can help spur you on.
Nohr,
of course,
one,
rather annoyed
two.
About that service fault. Made his feelings very clear about that. Right start here.
Oh. 4-1.
Yeah, nicely played, isn't it, by Oktavianti? She just saw the, I think, the hesitation and maybe lack of communication between the pair, the Danish pair, as to who was going to go up towards the net. I think she also seemed to be a little wrong-footed there. Magelund had a bit of a giggle at that, didn't she?
3-4.
Again, Nicholas is not happy. Service judges called it too high, but he's saying that
it's 1.15
is the height, and he's claiming that the service judges being unfair to him and that it was being done by their opponents as well. Everyone's on alert, aren't they? But he's got that in his mind now, psychologically. He's been playing that. Like I said, that can go one of two ways. When these things happen, either it constantly dogs you, or you use it to spur you on. We thought perhaps at the start of this second game that it might do the latter, but let's see. He's still muttering to himself. Jordan and Oktavianti, they've obviously not going to get distracted by all this and play their usual game. And it was lovely disguise, wasn't it, from Praveen Jordan. Jordan, I think, could have won that earlier.
7-6.
Opted not to use power.
Three,
That is more classic Jordan. To their credit, Nohr and Magelund are still very much in this. Showing their power as well, the Danish pair. Nicely done by Oktavianti. Great shot there from her.
Hey.
So it's over. Nine.
And then proceeds to do that. She's brushing it off. Well, it's one of the rare moments in this match, possibly just the second moment, and they've taken the lead outside of those opening few points.
So it's over. 10-4.
Certainly a much closer second game so far. Again, having a bit of a say. They are challenging that. It was in, but they felt that it had just gone out. I mean, Jordan not looking too impressed at the moment. Well, that's pretty clearly in, surely. Let's have a look then on the Hawkeye. Well and truly in.
11, 10,
and so the Indonesian pair go into the interval just ahead here, 11-10. Now, an important period here for Magelund and Nohr to stay in this match. They don't want Oktavianti and Jordan to build up a lead, and I say that now, and it's...
So it's over.
They've done 11, well here.
12.
Service four point, too high. Service over, 13-11.
Here is that more service woes. Less argument this time. Three points ahead now. Beginning to assert themselves at a good point. Good juncture in this game. Enforced by Praveen Jordan.
12-14.
That's consistencies. Something that's quite often mentioned about him. Now 3 points.
15-12.
It's the biggest lead anyone's had in this game since the start of it. Right at the beginning, they had a couple of point leads, a couple of points in the lead, Magelund and Nohr. But now, Jordan and Oktavianti are starting to run away with it. And if they want to stay in this match,
15-12.
They've got to do something now. Great net play there by Oktavianti. Lovely drive between
13,
the two.
12.
Managed to pull one back, but they've got to put a run together here.
Out. So it's over.
Well, that's disappointing, isn't it? Really nicely done by Praveen Jordan. And on that note, it gives him and Oktavianti 7 match points.
So it's over. 14-20.
Pull one back here. Nohr and Magelund, and they need to win the next 6 points to stay in this. It's a big ask. They haven't managed to do that yet
15,
in this match, 6
20.
In a row. And now it's 5.
Yeah. 16,
well, that was a good 20. Chance to finish things off, wasn't it, for Oktavianti? And there you have it. Nicely done by Jordan and Oktavianti.
Next one by Praveen Jordan.
Maybe not quite at their best.
Oktavianti.
Perhaps
21, 17,
Nicholas Nohr in particular
16.
Didn't help himself at times. But it is Pravin Jordan and Malati diver Oktavianti who beat Nicholas Nohr and Amelie Magelund 21-17, 21-16.